What would you say to your critics who say, oh, she's of a certain age or any of those things? Because I'm sure there's those morons out there who were thinking that.
So is this a certain age question or a certain gender question?
Oh, yes. Yes, ma'am, for sure.
I want to tell you about the decision I made to run for office. Not for president, but the one I made, it actually isn't that very long ago, back for the 2012 Senate race in Massachusetts. So here's how the world looks. I've been in Washington setting up the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau. You know why some Republicans hate that agency so much? It's not only the money it costs the big banks, it's the fact that it proves we can make government work for the people. Yep. So, setting up the consumer agency, you remember pre-approved credit cards? I was a pre-rejected nominee. That is, the Republicans told President Obama, we will never confirm that woman to be the head of the agency. Eh, so be it. So I head back. I would have stayed. I really would have. But that's the deal. I'm a big girl, so I head back to Massachusetts. And I'm going back to teaching. I love teaching. And people start calling me. There is a very popular Republican incumbent in the Senate who's coming up for re-election. Now, Massachusetts loves its moderate Republicans. This guy has a 65% approval rating. He has $10 million in the bank, which sounded like a lot of money at that time. And he had a pickup. And so people would call me and they would say to me, Elizabeth, you should run against him. You should get out. You should definitely run for this office. You're not going to win, but you should run. Now, I have to say, my first response is, Democrats, get a better sales pitch. Damn. And why was I not going to win? Well, because that guy a few years earlier had just beaten a, dare I say it, woman. Oh dear. And as people said to me, friends said to me, you know, Massachusetts is just not gonna elect a woman senator or governor. Not now. Maybe next generation, but not your generation. That's just not gonna happen. So, you know how I heard that. Get in the race. Right? Do this. But here's what I decided. I decided I would be in this fight, and there would be two things I would do every single day. The first one is I would make every day count to get out and talk about what's broken and how we fix it. To get out and talk about childcare, to talk about student loans, to talk about the housing crisis in this country, that people just can't afford decent housing, to talk about a broken criminal justice system. Every single day, I would find a group of people somewhere, somehow, and I would move the needle a little by dint of just sheer determination. The second thing I determined, said I would do, I said this to myself, I'm gonna see a little girl every day, at least one. And when I do, I'm gonna get down on my knees and I'm gonna say, hello, my name is Elizabeth, and I'm running for Senate because that's what girls do. We would do pinky promises to remember. And we took lots of pictures and lots of pinky promises. So here's the deal. I started out against that guy who simply could not be beaten. I started out down 17 points. I beat him by 7.5. And that's how I see this. You know, you're right. Maybe it takes a woman of a certain age to say, I know how to fight, I know how to win, and that's exactly what I'm going to do.